Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I've done many tutorials showing how to use the 3D filter in Photoshop to create the look of powerful, effective 3D images. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create the look of 3D text with deep shadows and bright reflections without using the 3D filter. We'll begin by creating a new document. Press Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Give your document a name and make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 300 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the small box to open the color picker. In the brightness field, type in 5% and click OK on both windows. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the empty layer with black. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the flyout list. Click Black and click OK. Change the blend mode to screen. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the brightness 125% and the lens type 50 to 300 millimeter zoom. Drag the lens flare approximately here in the preview window and click OK. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. The reason for this is so we can adjust, change, or remove the effects that we'll be adding to it. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 90 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. We're ready to set our text. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using Agency FB Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 100 points, but you may want to adjust this amount based on the font you choose and the amount of characters in your text. The aliasing is sharp and the alignment is centered. Click the color box. In the brightness field, type in 35%. Then click OK. Click on your document and type out your text. To center it on your document, click your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Since we'll be adding deep shadows to the bottom of the text, let's slide the text up a bit by pressing the up arrow on your keyboard approximately this much. Convert the text into a smart object. Click the FX icon and click Bevel and Emboss. Make the style inner bevel, the technique chisel hard, and the depth 100%. Make the direction up and the size 3 pixels. Make the angle 135 degrees and the altitude 50 degrees. The highlight mode is screen with an opacity of 75%. The shadow mode is linear burn, and its opacity is also 75%. Then click OK. Make the lens flare active and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag the copy above your text layer and hide its blur filter. Presently, the lens flare is showing through the text and the background. However, we want it to show only through the text and not the background. To do this, we'll make the lens flare copy into a clipping mask, which will clip it to the one layer below it, which is the text. To do this, press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Next, we'll begin the process of making the deep three-dimensional shadows. Ctrl-click or Command-click the thumbnail of your text to make a selection of it. Hide the text layer and make layer 1 active. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above the active layer. In this empty layer, we'll fill the selection with black. Open the Fill window. It remembers the last fill content, which was black, so just press Enter or Return. Then, deselect it. Next, we'll create an action to build our deep shadow. Open your Actions panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Actions. Click the icon on the right and click New Set. Name it Shadows and click OK or press Enter or Return. Immediately, a new action set was added to your Actions panel. Click the icon again and this time click New Action. The new action window will pop up. Click the Record button. Now, every step you'll do will be added to this action. It doesn't record the time between your steps, it only records the steps themselves, so take your time. The first step in your action is to make a copy of layer 2, which is the selection of our text that we filled with black. Press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of it. Double-click the copy to open its layer style window. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is Multiply, and the opacity is 100%. Uncheck Global Light, and make the angle 135 degrees. The distance is 2 pixels, and the spread and size is 0. Then click OK. Merge the Layer 2 copy with Layer 2 by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Then, click the Stop button to stop recording your actions. Click the action to make it active, and click the Play button. Each time you click the Play button, it will add 2 more pixels to the depth of your shadow. I'll click it approximately 30 times to make a solid shadow this deep. Let's rename this layer 3D Shadow. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Name the copy Blur Shadow and reduce its opacity to 60%. Make your text layer visible, but keep your Blur Shadow layer active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 10 pixels and click OK. Drag the blurred shadow down and to the right. Next, I'll show you how to change its colors. Scroll to the top and make your top layer active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Color Balance. There are 3 tonal ranges: shadows, midtones, and highlights. Within each tonal range, there are 3 color bars that show the color changes for the red, green, and blue channels. By dragging a slider towards a color, you'll increase that color in the image. Have fun experimenting with various color combinations in all 3 tonal ranges until you get the look you want. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.